In this video series, we are going to study science chapters of grade 10 SEE exams. Now we are going to start a physics chapter, electricity and magnetism. So in this series, we have been solving questions from your set book, one of your set books. Now we are going to solve questions of group A, 1 mark questions, and group B, 2 mark questions. Okay, so these are the questions. These questions are mainly from electromagnetic induction and few questions are from motor effect, right? So in this chapter, we have understood that, you know, magnetism can be produced from electricity, right? A current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. Whenever current is flowing in a conductor, it behaves like a magnet. We have seen this in electromagnetism. Okay, so that is magnetism being produced from electricity. Now in this case, this is the reverse one, okay, opposite of previous one. Electricity can be produced from magnetism. Okay, electricity can be produced from magnetism. So there is correlation between magnetism and electricity. Okay, correlation between electricity and magnetism, right? So this we are going to see in electromagnetic induction, how electricity can be produced from magnetism, right? So electromagnetic induction. Question number one, define electromagnetic induction. What is electromagnetic induction? Definition of electromagnetic induction. Whenever magnetic flux linked to a closed circuit changes, an EMF is induced in the circuit. This is induced current and the process is called electromagnetic induction. Phenomenon is called electromagnetic induction. Again, whenever magnetic flux linked to a closed circuit changes, an EMF is induced in the circuit. Okay, so here in this definition, you understood closed coil. Yes, there is another word also, that is magnetic flux. Okay, you need to understand the word magnetic flux. Now let's take a bar magnet. A bar magnet has north and south poles in it. There are always two poles in a magnet. Okay, and if you bring magnetic materials close to this magnet, then these materials will get attracted to the magnet. Supposing there is an iron pin, okay, you bring an iron nail close to this magnet, then this will get attracted to the magnet. That is because of magnetic field around this magnet. Okay, that magnetic field is because of magnetic lines of force. Yes, magnetic lines of force emerge out from north pole and go to south pole. Okay, this is the direction of magnetic lines of force, right? These are always coming out from north pole and going into south pole. Yes, magnetic field around the magnet is because of magnetic lines of force. Because of magnetic field, iron and other materials get attracted to the magnet. Yes, iron like material get attracted to the magnet. So this is magnetic lines of force. Now in this case, now you see, if you keep a closed coil close to this magnetic lines of force, then some magnetic lines of force will pass through the surface of the coil this way. Yes, magnetic lines of force will be cutting the closed coil in a perpendicular manner, right? Now in this case, the number of lines of force passing through the surface at a given time, right, this is magnetic flux. How many magnetic lines of force are passing through the surface at a particular time, this is magnetic flux. Okay, if you keep a closed coil and magnet close to each other, then more number of lines will be passing through the surface, so in that case flux will be more. And if you keep these two things far away, then magnetic lines of force will be less on the surface. Okay, yes, so this is magnetic flux. Understood? So magnetic lines of force passing through the surface at a particular time, this is magnetic flux, right? So the definition says, whenever there is change in magnetic flux has to change, and which is linked to the closed coil, right? Complete circuit. So lines, magnetic lines of force has to change, means sometimes it has to be maximum, sometimes it has to be minimum. Okay, amount has to change, and that if that change occurs, then current will be produced in this coil, okay, that is induced EMF, and that is current, and this process is called electromagnetic induction, right? Here current will be produced, and current will be produced due to some kind of influence, induction, okay? Induction means influence, okay? So this is electromagnetic induction. The whole process is electromagnetic induction, right? So this is electromagnetic induction. Now question number two, what is dynamo? Dynamo is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Dynamo is used in bicycle to glow bulb. Yes, to produce light, to glow bulb. Now you see dynamo is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Now let's see the simplified diagram of dynamo. We are going to study the working of dynamo in next part, okay? I'll give you basic idea. This is a closed coil. Yes, closed coil is connected with a ball. Here is a ball. Yes, now there is a magnet placed making close to it north pole and south pole, permanent magnet, and magnet is made to rotate with the help of this axle, okay? This axle is in touch with the rotating wheel over here. This is the wheel of bicycle, right? Wheel of bicycle. So as the wheel, you know, rotates, this axle will rotate, and as a result this magnet will be rotating around on top of this coil, close to coil, right? Whenever magnet, you know, rotates around being close to this coil, then there will be change in magnetic flux, okay, in this closed circuit, okay, that produces current, and that current will make the ball glow over here, right? So there will be change in magnetic flux whenever magnet is sitting at this position. Magnetic lines of force will be passing in this direction, and when it rotates, north pole will go here and south pole will come here, okay? There will be change in magnetic flux. Magnetic flux will be traveling in this manner, okay? So whenever this change occurs, there will be maximum magnetic flux, minimum magnetic flux, okay, in a repeated manner. That change in magnetic flux will produce current in this coil, and that makes the ball glow, okay? So here, whenever magnet is sitting, not moving, stationary, then current will not produce in this coil. But when magnet starts to move, it starts rotating around, okay, that movement will produce current in the coil. So here the point is movement, motion plays the key role, okay? That is why mechanical energy is converting into electrical energy. Motion of this magnet will produce current in this coil. That is why the device, it is a device which changes mechanical energy into electrical energy. Yes, on which principle does it work? It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. This whole process is electromagnetic induction, right? So this is dynamo. Now question number three, how can we produce a stronger current in bicycle dynamo, or how can we glow the bulb brighter in bicycle dynamo? How can we make the bulb brighter in bicycle? So answer for this question is, if you increase the speed of rotation of this magnet, then bulb will glow faster. Yes, when bicycle, you know, moves faster, then the bulb will glow brighter, right? And secondly, there is another way also. If you increase the number of coil over here, that will also make the bulb glow brighter, okay? So these are the ways. Either magnet has to rotate in a faster way, increasing the speed of rotation, and number two, by increasing the number of coil in the circuit, okay? So these are, there are other ways also. Now let's mention only this two here. Now number four, what is generator? On which principle does it work? Actually, generator is just like dynamo. Dynamo is in smaller form and generator in bigger form, right? Dynamo produces less current, the generator produces more current, okay? Dynamo is used in bicycle, vehicles, okay, and generator is used in hydropower stations, okay, to produce large amount of current. So here is the simplified figure of generator. It works exactly on this principle, right? So this is the simpler one. Yes, so what is generator? Generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy, just like this one. Okay, mechanical energy into electrical energy. Now here in this case, the closed coil will move in the magnetic field. Okay, now in the previous case, what you understood was magnet was rotating around being close to coil. Yes, so there is a magnet, there is a coil, there are two things. Okay, and either of these has to move. Okay, one of these has to move, that is relative motion. There should be relative motion. Okay, either magnet has to move or coil has to move in order to change the flux, right? In order to make the magnetic flux more or less, so that current will be produced in the circuit. Now in this diagram, in case of generator, we'll make the coil move instead of magnet. In this case, magnet moved. Now here we'll see how coil moves and it produces current. Now this is a magnet, north pole and south pole. Magnetic lines of force are passing from north to south always, and there is a coil, okay, closed coil circuit. Yes, now this coil will move up and down by being perpendicular to the lines of force. Yes, this closed coil will move up and down. Yes, we'll make this coil move up and down in repeated manner, and when it happens, magnetic flux will be changing close related to this coil, right? Magnetic flux will be less, magnetic flux will be more when the coil moves up and down in this magnetic field, right? So when coil comes right at the center of this magnetic flux, there will be maximum magnetic flux. When it goes extreme down, there will be less. When it goes extreme up, there will be less. So there will be change in magnetic flux, okay, linked to this closed coil, right? So that will produce current in this closed coil, right? So this is also electromagnetic induction. It is the same process, right? So generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Here is mechanical energy movement. Again, movement is playing the key role over here. Motion of this coil up and down in the magnetic field. Okay, that is the motion. Yes, so motion, mechanical energy is producing electrical energy in this closed coil. Yes, so this is electromagnetic induction. Then this machine, okay, device is generator. Generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. On which principle does it work? It works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Generator is used to produce large amount of current, usually large amount of current. Now question number 5, how can we increase the magnitude of induced current in generator, or sometimes we call it induced EMF also, right? EMF also you word use. Okay, magnitude means strength. Induced EMF means that is simply current. You understand it as current in generator. How can we increase the strength of current in this generator? Again, the same thing, by increasing the number of coils, okay, by making the more number of coils, and another one, increasing the speed of movement. Okay, so by making the movement faster over here, we can increase the magnitude of induced EMF. Yes, two ways, by increasing the speed of movement, by increasing the number of coil. Okay, you understand, remember 2 points, it is easier. There are more ways, we'll discuss it later. Number 6, what is motor effect? Motor effect is opposite of electromagnetic induction, right? We will see here. In motor effect, you see there are 2 bar magnets. Let's keep 2 bar magnets. Okay, north pole, south pole, north, south. There is a magnetic lines of force passing from north to south. Okay, you keep a conductor over here in the middle, right? Now conductor is having current in it. It is having current in it. Okay, current is flowing through this conductor. Now the conductor has current in it and it is kept in the magnetic field, right? Now in this case, this conductor will move up and down. Conductor will be moving up and down in this magnetic field, okay, and current is passing through it at the same time, right? So this is motor effect. This is motor effect. When a current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, okay, it moves if it is allowed to do so, if it is given a space to move. Okay, this is called motor effect. Again, a current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, it moves if it is allowed to do so. It moves in the magnetic field. This is called motor effect. That is because of this one. There is a magnetic field. There is already one magnetic field over here. Okay, magnetic lines of force passing from north to south poles over here. And when conductor is having current in it, current is flowing in it, this conductor also changes into magnet. We know this from electromagnetism. A current carrying conductor behaves like a magnet. We have understood this one. So this current conductor is also a magnet and there is also another magnet. Okay, so two magnetic fields are, you know, reacting to each other in this case, right? So there is one magnet, there is another magnet, and there are two magnetic fields, okay, reacting with each other. And this two magnetic fields cause attraction and repulsion. Attraction, repulsion, attraction, repulsion. So that makes the conductor move up and down. Okay, interaction between two magnetic fields make the conductor move up and down in this magnetic field. Okay, this is motor effect, right? So when current carrying conductor is kept in a magnetic field, it moves if it is allowed to do so. This is called motor effect, right? So current carrying conductor will move up and down in the magnetic field. This is motor effect. Name the devices that work on the basis of motor effect. So the devices are electric motors. Electric motors of all kinds, right? So devices are fan, electric fan. Devices are, you know, water pump, okay, and washing machine, okay, and vacuum cleaner, refrigerator. All these work on the principle of motor effect. And all these machines or devices are electric motors. Electric motors are used in them, right? So this is motor effect. Okay, what is electric motor? Electric motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Electrical energy, this conductor is having electrical energy in it and it moves. Okay, so electrical energy is converting into mechanical energy movement, right? So electric motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Electrical energy into mechanical energy. Electrical energy into mechanical energy. All these devices, fan, electric fan, water, water pump, okay, washing machine, all these change electrical energy into mechanical energy, right? They move. Now differentiate between generator and electric motor. Differences between generator and electric motor. So differences are very simple. Generator and electric motor. Generator, electric motor. Okay, number one point. Generator works on the principle of electromagnetic induction. Electric motor works on the principle of motor effect. Okay, now in case of generator, mechanical energy changes into electrical energy. In case of electric motor, electrical energy is changed into mechanical energy. Right? Number three point, generator, current is produced. Current is produced. induced, current is produced, induced, okay. Electric motor, current is used, by using current, the mechanical energy will be produced, right. So these are the differences between generator and electric motor. Now in the next part, we will see working of dynamo, working of generator, working of electric bell, etc. Okay, working of transformer, okay, we will see, and filament lamp, fluorescent lamp, etc.